told the praise and worship team, Philip is prepared because God has just mixed everything around, and I had all my things planned out and everything was to the T, and God came and he changed everything around. And I need to share scripture with you. Can I share this scripture with you? I can just get there quickly. 1 Peter 1 verse 23, it says there, for you have been born again, not of perishable seed, but of imperishable seed, through the living and enduring word of God. As the prophet was speaking earlier on in the previous session, and we were talking about the grapes, I saw the seed, this imperishable seed that has been planted from within us. The Almighty God came and he planted a seed in us. Now this day, as you are standing here, as you are sitting here, for too long that we take a seed and we've put it on the shelf because we want to save it. Right. The minute we take a seed and we put it on a shelf, it is worth nothing. It is literally worth nothing. But the minute we take that seed and we put it in the ground and we nurture that seed, it will come forth. Now let me tell you, if apples bear apples, God's seed bears God. Holy Spirit seed that has been planted within each and every one of us. What do you think will come forth if we allow the seed to burst forth? My brother, my sister, before we continue, you can play that, brother. But before we continue with a song today, now is the time to release that seed. Now is the time to release that. Therefore, this day, we are moving into the new. We are moving into the new.
Amen.
And it is time to plant that seed so that God can come and nurture you. So you run to the front if you need that seed to be released in your life right now. You run to the front. They're going to sing later. Come, 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 come. You're going to run to the front. We're going to release that seed right now. Let me tell you, I have always been a prisoner in my own mind, because I stood and I said, you know what, I'm just a pastor. I always thought in my mind, I'm just a pastor in this whole big fivefold ministry. Who am I? Who am I? And you know what God said? He said, but if you are so little, why did my son die for you? If you are so little, why did my son die for you? My brother, my sister, as you are sitting here today, if you think you are too little, if you think you are not strong enough, not clever enough, if the seed that has been planted inside of you has not yet been released, it is time now, because Jesus died on the cross. He died so that we can have this release. And like I told you, I have always been intimidated. I have always been captured in my mind with all these loud screaming pastors, because I'm the cute one, amen. I'm the handsome one about them all. I have always been intimidated, because who am I? And today, as you are standing here, let me tell you, I've been there when you are standing right now. I had to walk this road where I felt I wasn't good enough. I had to walk this road where I had to come and take captive these thoughts that the enemy is keeping against me day after day. These thoughts that the enemy has put in my place to say, you are not strong enough. These thoughts kept me away from my destiny for so long. For so long. But I realized what my God is capable of. I know what my God can do. Because let me tell you, Jesus did not. He did not suffer on a cross. He did not die. He suffered on a cross in vain. Just close your eyes for a minute as you are standing here. And today, I know there's still someone out there sitting that do not want to come to the front, and I'm praying for you as well. But as you are standing here right now, this very minute, the world has hurt you before. Yes, that's true. People have let you down. Yes, that is true. Today, my brother, my sister, the Almighty God wants to ask you, when, my child, did something from this earth die for you? My child, as you are standing here, show me one place where the world and their pagan gods forgave your sins. My child, as you are standing here, show me a way where these pagan gods have set you free. Because these pagan gods, the god of this age, is there to blind. The god of this age is there to steal from you. And it is time to say no more. It is time to rise up and say enough. Because God says, I am more than a conqueror. God says, I am more than a conqueror. Now let me tell you, I have walked this road, and I know where you are standing, and God will not force himself on you. But right now, in the name of Jesus, I am standing on his authority. I am a pastor, part of the fivefold ministries. No, I'm not an apostle. No, I am not a prophet. I am a pastor. I am an anointed man of God. Because God says so. And right now, this very minute, as you are standing here, God says, you are an anointed person of him. You are his. And we just want to release the seed upon you right now in Jesus' name. Release, release, release in Jesus' name. Release from deep within in Jesus' name. Release, 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 release in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, Sarah Bahanda Baras. Achia Baras. Burst forth a harvest in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, birth forth your harvest which has been planned for you in the name of Jesus. Release, release, Zuleika, release in Jesus' name. We were busy this last 3 weeks with a spiritual preparation, and Pastor Jaden brought us such a special word, and I would like to share it. It's not my own word, but I would like to share it with you because God is laying it on my heart. I can just find my money. Where is it? Here we go. God shared this word with us, and as we are singing, I'm not forgotten. I have a 10 rand in my hand. I can leave this place now and I can buy a malfa pudding, yay? I have a 10 rand and I have 10 rands worth of money in my hand. How many times have you felt like $1 million? You felt so rich. You felt so special. You felt so awesome. And then we reach a stage where the enemy comes and is still kill and destroy. And without us knowing it, we've opened up a door and we've allowed the enemy to come in. And it feels as if my worth is going lesser and lesser and lesser. Eventually, I am all creased up, tossed away in the winds. How many times have you found yourself in a place? Don't take it. Okay. You see, the apostle said, if you see a paper, pick it up. No, you're interfering with my teaching. Amen. Bless you. Amen. All right, so how many times in your life have you felt tossed away, forgotten? Have you ever been in that place where you said, God, where are you? God, have you forgotten about me? God says, I have not forgotten about you. Even though the enemy came and he stole from you, he will restore it. And I still have my 10 rand worth. I can still go and buy my malfa pudding without asking for discount. Because I haven't lost my life. My brother, as you are sitting here, my sister, as you are sitting here, you are not forgotten. The Almighty God did not forget about you. But that was not my teaching. That's God doing his own thing again. Okay. So that's wonderful. You are not forgotten as you are standing here. Romans 8 verse 13 to 15 says, for if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the misdeeds of your body, you will live. For those who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. The Spirit you receive does not make you slaves so that you live in fear again. Rather, the Spirit you received brought about you adoption of sonship. And by Him we cry, Abba Father. This new, as we are moving in, is not meant for you to go back into slavery. They are not supposed to look back as the Egyptians, as the Israelites look back to Egypt. And they said, I want to go back to the meat pots. We are not meant to look back, my brother, my sister, as we are moving into this new. Remember the prophet said, make sure you know what you say yes to. You're going to have to swallow it. You're going to have to drink it. And as we are moving in this, it is never meant to put you back in sleep. We don't like change. We don't like to adopt. And it feels as if we're somewhere in the desert. You know what? Sometimes God allows a desert season in your life so that He can teach you to rely fully on Him. In this time of change, as we are moving into this new, it has never been meant for slavery, but to set you free. Now you will need to take that new, and you need to walk bold. And as I'm talking about this boldness, I can't help thinking about Paul when he was in Athens. Where was he? Let's read it. Acts 17, verse 16 to 32. When Paul was in Athens, he went and he started to speak boldly about the God. Not the God, our God. And he said, I know you are very religious. I know you are very committed to these gods that you are worshipping. He says, but I have this, you are praying to an unknown God. Let me tell you, who is this unknown God? He stood in the streets and he says, come, I need to tell you. Come, you need to hear. Come, let me show you what my God can do. Boldly, he spread the gospel. He even went so far to go into the synagogues, all those Jews. And he says, can I tell you about Jesus, the Messiah? How bold is that? And then some of them went, if you go read it. Sorry, I'm jumping. If you go read it, you will see. Some of them says, what is this blabber trying to tell us? What is this new teaching you are irritating our ears with? And some just brushed it off. While others take it. So tell me more about this God. Tell me more. My brother, my sister, now as we are moving into the new, it is time for us to become like Paul. It is time for us to take those steps and to be bold for Christ.
Amen.
Do you think Paul never received any judgment? Do you think Paul never received any rejection from while he was preaching there outside in the street? No. He was rejected. People rejected him. People says, what is this blabbering in my ears you're talking about? I don't want to hear it. Yet he continued. And he rose up and he was bold. It is time for you and I in this new to rise up and be bold for what our God can do. You know, so often in our churches, now this is where the cute part comes in. I've actually practiced this, okay? This is now where it comes in our services, in our churches. Let's call it in the church today. We all sit at the distance. Who was speaking about the distance? First of all, we're speaking about the distance. We're sitting in church and it says, oh, he got saved. So cute. Hallelujah, he got saved. Yeah, he got saved. We sit in churches and we say, oh, did you hear? He started talking to us today. That's the queen in me coming out. I'm actually very butch. Okay? That is what we do. That is what we do in church. But it is time for you and I to rise up and say, my sister, do you know Jesus? Yeah. Not come. Yes. Come. Yes. I'm not waiting for a pastor. I'm not waiting for an elder. Yes. Come. You need to know Jesus. Yes. And it is time for the body of Christ. It is time for the saints to rise up and say, you need to know Jesus. Yes. It is time that you and I stand up and say, you need to know I know God.
That's right.
We are living in a time of so many pagan gods. What does scripture tell us about pagan gods? The god of this age, it is blinding the people. It is blinding the people. My brother, my sister, why isn't this church 14,000 seats big? Because the god of this age has blinded so many and they are lost. It is time for you and I to rise up as the church and go and spread the gospel the way Paul spread the gospel. Can you imagine what would have happened if Paul decided, oh no, I'm facing too much rejection, and now I'm leaving it? Can you imagine what would have happened while Paul was in jail and he decided, oh. That's what we do.
It is.
Ain't telling me. It's the porch thing. Whenever I go and worship there, I porch this. That's most what we do in church. You ain't telling me, Pastor. That's what we do. That's what we do. You know who I am. Hello. Do you know during the week, the work that I do, I'm a very important person. If Paul decided to end, how many souls would have gone lost? How many people would not have heard the word of God? But Paul was man. He died. His soul is still alive, but he died. The flesh is dead. But the legacy needs to move forth. We need to go and we need to birth these parents to go and take the legacy forward. To go and spread the gospel of the unknown God to the world. It is time for you and I to rise up and take the crown. The title deed is ours. And it is time we go and we take that crown back. For too long that the enemy and the pagan gods and the god of this age had ownership of what belongs to the kingdom. For too long that we put an okay stamp on something that is not okay. How many times, let's get a bit more personal. How many times in our churches today, I'm talking about Boxburg, Beth Aron, I love you all. Let's talk about Agalia, let's talk about Springs, let's talk about Day of Gloria, let's talk about Bloemfontein. Amen. How many times in your church have you seen, oh, and Potchefstroom. How many times in your church have you seen people brushing off a teacher? Just because they don't understand. Oh, don't come and blabber here in my ears. Don't come and tell me about speaking in tongues. Don't come and tell me about the healing, the laying of hands and healing that will take place. Let me tell you, the gift of the Holy Spirit is not only for Pentecost season. The gift of the Holy Spirit is there for 365 days a year. How many times have we seen people brushing off these teachings? This is not for me. This is not for me. You go and speak in your tongues. You go and lay your hands. You go and be a clown. You go and jump around. It's fine. I want to be a clown. Oh, yes. I want to be a clown. Yes. Do not allow a religious mindset to steal from you. We have spoken about the mind last night, Apostle. How many times have you found yourself or found yourself in jail like Paul was in jail? Yeah, in your mind. God, I am not clever enough. Can I share testimony with you? Am I allowed to give a testimony? Can I tell you? For years, I'm not talking about months, for years, I have been intimidated. I have shared this with the apostle. For years, I have been intimidated. I thought, who am I? I get it, Pastor Peter, and I said, he's got a beautiful voice. He's got such an anointing upon his life and on his ministry. Such a blessed man. There's Pastor L, there's Pastor J. People love them. They know how to speak. I'm trying to know, how do they get to react with people so personally? They do it as if it's a second nature. I can't do that. I looked at Pastor's time, Pastor Glenn, and said, playing instruments. I can't even play the drums, even if it's just doof doof. Such blessed people. I look at the fivefold ministries, the apostles, the prophets, and they are on fire, and they are anointed. And as they speak, the people drop like flies. And I thought, where do I fit into this picture? And God said, you are my child. You are not forgotten. You were never meant to be someone else. You were meant to be you. My brother, my sister, for years I have found myself in a jail. But I hold on to God. God, I am inferior. Whenever I'm in a conference, whenever I'm in a gathering, I felt so inferior. I felt so less worthy than the next. I was in jail, but I kept on. And I worshiped God. And I stuck it out. And I stuck it out, although here in my heart, here in my mind, so many things were going on. Because I also want to be as clever as they are. I also want to... Okay, I am handsome, amen. He was supposed to shout amen, not laugh. Amen, amen. What I'm saying is, for years the enemy has kept me locked in this jail. But because I persevered, God has saved. In your life, my brother, my sister, in your life, do not allow the enemy to keep you captive.
That's right.
Do not allow the enemy to keep you holding in that cell, because that is not where God wants you. God wants you to rise up. You don't have to be a pastor to tell someone about Jesus. You don't have to be a pastor to go and pray for someone and lay your hands on them. Because the gift of the Holy Spirit is there for everyone. So it is time for the saints to rise up and say, you need to know Jesus. You need to know Jesus. And if the enemy tells you that you are not strong enough, if the enemy tells you that you are not clever enough, what did the apostle say?
Shut up!
I love it. That's going to be a new slogan. Slogan. That's my... You sound Italian if you speak Afrikaans. I sound Italian if I speak English. That is a new slogan in amongst God's people. Shut up. Because we are worth it. We are worth it. We are worth it. Let me tell you. When I got this word about the seed that has been planted, if I take a bean and I plant it in the ground. Okay, no, we spoke about grapes. I love grapes. Let's speak about that seed, that grape seed. I have one grape and there's one seed inside that grape. And I plant it. I can pick my seed, I can leave it on the shelf, and I will have a seed for the next 10 years. I can plant it. That's you. That's the seed, each and every one of us. The scriptures say you've got the seed. Yeah? Amen? So we can take that seed and we can plant it. We can have a vine. We can have a vine. And we can have a harvest of seeds year after year after year after year. And as we are moving into the new, as we are allowing God to renew us, we can have that harvest that has been attended for you. You can have that harvest. Isn't God amazing? Isn't God just, there's no words for Him. Amazing seems so small. And fantastic if we refer to God, seems so insignificant. Our God is just fantastic. Amen. Hallelujah. I have had this in my spirit and I have shared it with the apostle. You know what? Before me, being very organized, my sermon has been worked out 3 months back and I have been ready. I haven't even looked at my notes. I think I had two scriptures here. But let me tell you, God has laid on my heart that it is time for the church to rise up and usher in the sound, because there is people that needs to hear. And I just loved it. And before the session, I was standing out here on the patio and I looked and I said, your trees is about to lose all their leaves because the people of God is going to shake them off. It is time, like Paul stood up and he spread the gospel for us here today, to rise up and usher out that sound. Praise the Lord. Do not let the enemy at this very minute do what do. Whatever you do, don't break the sticks this year, please.
It's our own sticks.
My brother, my sister, as you are sitting here, I have not read this in a book. I have not done some other study. I have lived it. The enemy kept me captive. The enemy kept me away from who I am. He kept my power and my authority away from me. The seed has been released upon your life. There was still someone in this seat that did not come forward. I do not know who you are, but I know you are here. And that seed needs to be released upon your life. And as we sat here right now, that seed has been released. It is ready for that seed to start growing and start bearing fruit. And right now, this very minute, I want us to usher out that sound. And as we are ushering out that sound, I want you to usher it out with authority and with power. Because the Spirit of God is not powerless. The Spirit of God is not there only for Pentecostal seasons. It is there for you. Can we please stand? Can we please stand? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, Sarah Bahanda Barasi. Thank you, Jesus. Just worship God there where you stand right now. Just worship God. Just worship Him. Just tell Him how great He is. Just allow the Spirit of God to touch you this very minute right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 I want this to build. I want this to build on this. I want this. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise and worship team, please come up. Let me tell you, as we are ushering out this sound, this wind is blowing. This wind is blowing.
Yes.
And it just touches us. It just touches up the people out there, because there are people that need to hear the sound.
Yes.
Now, as you are standing here, religion has told us, you don't blink your eyes when you go. Religion has told the church that you had to stand up straight and be all humble. Religion has told the people of God that we are not allowed to have fun. Why did Jesus die on a cross then? What does it mean to have life and life to the fullest?
Yes.
Now that song, as we are singing this song, the apostle spoke about the robe and the ring on my finger. He puts a robe on my back right now as we are singing this song. Accept the robe.
Yes.
Accept the robe.
Yes.
That ever Father wants to put on your shoulders. A jacket is worth nothing if it hangs in your cupboard. Unless you put it on, as you are standing in the presence right now, and as we are singing this song, take that robe and put it around your shoulders. Embrace God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I do not want to leave this place until I know that every single person in this place right now has activated that seed to bring forth the harvest.
Yes, Jesus.
I do not want you to leave this place if there is someone who's gone, still lying, or whose robe is still lying in the cupboard somewhere. My beloved, if you are standing here today and you say, God, I need you in my life because my thoughts, and I know we have read about this, but I am just following the Spirit. I'm just following the Spirit. And if you are standing here and says, God, I have been in jail like Paul has been in jail. Need to be set free, then you run to the front. If you are standing here today and you say, God, my robe has been hanging in my cupboard and I never had the guts to put it on because I am scared of the unknown. Let me tell you, last year Destiny Apostle came and she released healing before I prayed for someone. Let me tell you, you cannot imagine the healing that took place when I laid my hands on people afterwards. And I believe that the pastors and the apostles, the fivefold ministry, as we are standing here, we have the power and the authority to move mountains. Let the enemy keep you away. Do not let the enemy keep you in your seat, because he has been lying to you for too long. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Pastor, I feel like Pastor Randy and I need to say hands for you to give.
apprenticeship that God wants to do. You're coming into your own. You're coming into your own. You're finding your feet and your place.
I woke up yesterday morning and the Holy Spirit said to me, incorruptible seed. And he kept saying it over and over and over, and it was in my spirit. And the more he said, I was wondering what was up with this. And as soon as you opened your Bible, I felt the Lord saying, and I felt the Lord saying, this is a confirmation. It wasn't so much what I was going to tell to do with it as much as take it off the shelf and plant it. And so, you know, this right here, what you said about take it off the shelf and plant it. The Lord right now is releasing a harvest for the seeds you've already planted. It's an incorruptible seed that you've deposited in the spirit realm over your area, over your city, over your region, and in that church. You've been sowing the incorruptible seed of the Word of God. It's incorruptible. It cannot be destroyed. And the Lord says it's going to begin to reap. You're going to begin to reap a harvest right now. You're seasoned for harvest. The shell is cracking. The shell is cracking. The shell is cracking. And the life is coming out of that seed. And it's beginning to burst forth. And it's pushing the soil back. And as it pushes that soil back, people are going to begin to see the green, the life, the flow. And right now, I speak in Jesus' name, the release, impartation of fire, the impartation of fire and strength in this next season. We sprinkle with the words of our mouth the blood of Jesus over Beth Aron, and we declare right now that that seed is breaking forth and bursting forth in Jesus' name.
Yes, I actually see it. I see it. I see it coming forth and turning green. I see that. I see acceleration, a speed, a camera when it's speeding up, that thing, I think they call it slowing down, but it's speeding up the process, and that's what God is doing, and I think it's happening all over the earth. So don't be surprised, Pastor Louis. Don't be surprised. Don't be surprised. The contacts, don't be surprised. Just recognize the legit ones. Know the right ones. Just there are many, many that will come, but just go to the right ones. The right ones, the right ones. Sure. And now, just as we stand here as apostles, we release that over you, the word you've spoken to others into yourself, and we release those dreams for the future. That seed that has been planted is coming to birth. Robo shit. Oh, she has.